Gentlemen, welcome to Silver West. Quick reminder, for any parents and guardians, if you are not here for the winter presentation, throughout the auditorium, you'll see the photo for the QR. So please take your device, do the same thing, you take your device, go up to it, open up the QR. That is the electronic program. It's located in 10 different locations around the auditorium, so if anybody needs to take a minute and do that, feel free. Second thing is that this program is live streamed, so this is live today on the Athletics YouTube channel. So if you have a family member who cannot make this program, totally fine. If you want to send them a text message, just let them know they have the ability to watch it live on the YouTube channel or watch it later on. So we're going to give you a few minutes if anybody wants to come up and utilize any of the QRs once again for the electronic program today.
And while that is going on, I'd just like to reiterate some things that I've gone over with you after our first two awards programs this year. I've been very pleased with the respect you're giving the speakers when they're up here. I expect the same. I know it's toward the end of the day, and I know it's toward the end of the year, but it's a time to be extremely respectful. We ask that you hold applause when a coach calls an entire team up. Please hold applause until they call the last person up. It's very helpful, okay? And it's important that you're quiet so everybody gets to hear what the speakers are saying. You've done a good job this year. Please keep that going. The program will begin pretty shortly. So bear with us.
Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Silver West, and thank you for taking time out of your day to join us. This time, I'd like to ask you all to please rise and join us in the Pledge of Allegiance. The flag is located over here. Pledge of Allegiance. and programs if anybody would like that as well. My name is Mr. David Eggleton, and I'm the athletic director here at Sullivan West. I'd like to thank the Sullivan West Central School District, the buildings and grounds teams here in Lake Huntington and the Jeff campus, the Sullivan West administrative team, the Board of Education, and most importantly, the Sullivan West spring athletic staff for their support and hard work throughout another season. I'd like to give a special thanks to the parents and guardians and families of these athletes for all their assistance, support, and communication throughout this spring season. I'd also like to give a special thank you to Mrs. Charlotte Schwartz, who is here today with us. She's on maternity leave, but she came baby in tow just to do the sounds and the lights today. So thank you so much, Mrs. Schwartz. Let's give her a round of applause. And I'd also like to thank Mrs. Ebert. Many of you know Mrs. Ebert. Mrs. Ebert is a new addition to the athletics office. She's been fantastic with clerical support and made for the spring programs to be much easier with all of her organizations. So thank you, Mrs. Ebert. Introduce, of course, the middle school principal, Mr. Scott Haberly. He's spent a lot of time with the students and these athletes, and we appreciate all that he does. I'd ask you to please hold your applause until I have announced all of the coaches for the spring staff. Modified track and field, Mr. Joe Ebling, and assistant coach, Mr. Scott Scardino. Modified softball, silver, Mr. J.P. Lang and assistant Mrs. Katrina Chellis. Modified softball blue, Mr. Dan Welton and assistant Karen Passante. Modified baseball, Mr. Augustin Casas, who was unable to be with us today due to the field trip to Frost Valley, as well as Mr. Scardino. Assistant coach, Ms. Karen Gabriel. Modified golf, Mrs. Patty Ruggles. Let's give them a round of applause. Hold your applause in between. We only have a short amount of time today. So your coaches are going to come up. They're going to introduce your team. They're going to call the rosters. Please wait. Please wait until all the names are called. Everybody is on stage before we give our round of applause, which we will absolutely do. But please make sure we hold that applause so that we have everything in time today. So to start off our awards today, I'd like to invite up Mr. Joe Ebling. The modified track and field team, we have Nicholas Arnold, Ashley Deal, Hunter Ebeling, Mitchell Everett, Luke Carbanos, Esteban Ramos, Aiden Scardino, Layla Wilkin, Nicholas Soldritz, and Callum Powell, and Kaylin Wilton Irvin, sorry. So, just to keep things moving here, the spring track season this year was a positive one. The weather early on cooperated for once this year, and we didn't have to spend the majority of our preseason inside running the halls of Jeffersonville. We had 11 student athletes on the team this year. All but two were brand new to outdoor track. Despite that fact, this group was able to do very well against all the teams we competed against this year. Everyone improved tremendously throughout the season. We had dominating performances against schools similar to our size, like Liberty, Fallsburg, and Tri-Valley. We were very competitive as a group against larger opponents, including Monticello, Goshen, Kingston City Schools, and Cornwall, schools with 70 to 120 kids on their team. That could be pretty intimidating when you walk
walk in with a group of 12, and these guys did awesome. At the Tri-Valley Invitational, against over 200 other athletes competing, we had some outstanding individual performances that should be noted. Aiden Scardino won the 800 and the long jump. Kaylee Melton-Erdman was second in the 200, took first in the long jump, and first in the 100 meter. Mayla Wilkin was third in the 800. And Hunter Evelyn was first in the high jump, the 100 and the 200. It was really a great season coaching these kids. I had a lot of fun. I'd like to thank my assistant coach, Mr. Scardino, who couldn't be here today because he was at Frost Valley, Mr. Eggleton for adding meets in to make sure we had a competitive season, and also thank all the varsity coaches who helped out with the younger team during the season to make sure we have a successful program in years to come. Thank you, guys. Invite up Coach Lang and Coach Chelsford.
Modified heels on the ball to the mark. Prepare the outcome.
this time, I'd like to invite up Mrs. Karen Gabriel. Excuse me, guys and girls, excuse me.
Thank you. My name is Trisha Rubles. I worked in the halls, in the gym, when available, and out in the fields. When we were able to create small groups, they teamed up and encouraged each other and supported each other. Once golf course opened up, we were invited to participate at the Villarome Golf Course, and the students received guidance from the pro, Matt Kleiner, who counseled each student a bit on techniques in improving their skills and focus. Soon the students were practicing the basics on the course itself. We hope to pair the modified group next year with the varsity team for help with techniques. A few of the students even made commitments with family support to purchase a full set of golf clubs. We began conversations about jobs at the golf course for some of the participants when it would be age appropriate. We always have access to clubs for students who do not have their own. I look forward to next year and hope that the students who are in the 7th and 8th will continue moving up to the 9th grade or the 8th grade team, modified, and will join the high school group with Mr. Donovan and Mr. Meyer's support. Through the generosity of the Villarome, the team is given the ability to go over to the course on and off season and play the course and bring someone with them. They are given this opportunity at no cost. Thank you to the community, Villarome, parents, colleagues, and students for supporting our modified golf team. Thank you.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, we are running out of time, so we'll be brief here, so I can turn it over to Mr. Baggerly for dismissal. In closing, Solomon West Athletics, we are excited about this group of young athletes and their effort in athletics. Overall, on the year, it has been incredible to see the participation numbers so far for modified athletes in Solomon West for 2021-2022. These athletes have learned how to be competitors, split time with their peers during competitions, make adjustments on a daily basis with weather cancellations, use good sportsmanship, be disciplined, and become team players. We wish them success in their future athletic experiences in the fall 2022 season. As an athletic director, this is a sad time of year because our athletic facilities look fantastic. So students, raise your hand if you'd like to stay in school for one extra month, so we can have the nicest weather to play baseball, softball, and golf. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's give a warm round of applause. Solomon West Athletics, 9-5. Thank you.
Students, stay seated.